You're a third-rate duelist with a fourth-rate deck.
Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today in Duel Links we have a new main box, Absolute Inferno featuring Red Dragon Archfiend. So many people wait for this card for so long, so it's finally here and that means we have one signer dragon left to get, and that is of course Black Rose Dragon from Akiza. Now this box, having 180 packs of course as a main box, contains the following archetypes. First of all, I will be talking about Fire Fists, and I also will give my free-to-play opinion about the box and the archetypes in it in the end of the video, so stay tuned for that. So, Fire Fists. I think they get great support. In my opinion, they were not viable so far. Now, they have a chance at being viable. First of all, this archetype gets Spirit and Bear as two ultra rares in this box, and also the card in my opinion that will be the main engine and searcher of the deck is Rooster. Rooster is a rare, which is good for the people that want to get the deck. Now, the downside is that you will be needing multiple of the ultra rares. I think 2 to 3 Spirit and probably 2 Bear depending on your version. The thing with Fire Fists though is that they have a lot of super rare monsters and cards from older boxes, and some of them are main boxes as well. So if you find yourself needing more Fire Fist cards that you don't already have from past boxes, you will be needing not only to dig through a main box for ultra rares, but to also dig through older boxes for super rares. And as a free-to-play, that move is probably one of the worst gem management moves you can make, because you will waste tons of gems for you to complete a deck that you're not even sure yet, we are not even sure yet, that it will be good in the game. I believe it can be a rogue deck, I am not sure how meta viable it will be. For that we need of course to let the players that spend money on the boxes build something, test it on the ladder, and then we're gonna know for sure. So let's continue with the archetypes. Next we have the Nephthys archetype. The word is pretty tough to pronounce, so bear with me, alright? Now, Cerulean Sacred Phoenix of Nephthys is a ritual monster. Yes, a ritual monster in 2019. To be exact, this card got released in the TCG late 2018. So it is pretty new in Yu-Gi-Oh! In general, not just Duel Links. It has a great effect, but it's still a ritual monster. That means a ritual deck won't be as consistent as a top-tier deck we have at the moment, Quakimiru, for example. So we have this card that is an ultra rare, and the bad thing is you will probably need it 3 times if you want to build a good Nephthys deck. We also have a super rare ritual, Devotee of Nephthys, and of course we also get the ritual spell, Rebirth of Nephthys, which has a good effect. Nothing wrong there, and it's just a normal card. So you will most likely need Sacred Phoenix that we already have in a way back in the past mini box. If you don't have that, maybe you don't even need to consider this deck. Will it be good? I'm not really sure. I think it can be a good rogue strategy. But the thing is, it can also be paired up with current decks we have in Duel Links. One of them is Yubel. And with Yubel, it can be super annoying, I'm sure of it, but it can be super inconsistent as well. If we think that Yubel is already kind of inconsistent, then we have a ritual deck. Mixing these two things together won't be the best result you can get as far as consistency goes. Now, you can also mix this deck up with Ancient Gears, since they have a lot of high level monsters, which means you can ritual summon easier. Although, Ancient Gears might be better off with just being alone, you know, without being paired up with a ritual monster. So, I'm not sure how this deck will impact the meta. I am 100% sure that it can be annoying in a rogue deck, but being meta, I don't see it at the moment at least. But they have super interesting effects, and that is nice to see. We keep going with the Laval archetype. I think that it is pretty interesting that you can also synchro summon pretty fast with this archetype as you can with Gusto. But like Gusto, you don't have anything crazy you can synchro summon into in order for the deck to be top tier immediately or even in the tier list. For example, Karakuri have a great monster they can synchro summon into, but Laval Not so much. We have Laval Val Dragon. It is an ultra rare 5-star synchro, not the best effect though. We also have Laval Dual Slasher and Laval Val Dragoon, but they are not amazing synchro monsters either. So we have a pretty nice engine for synchro summoning, not the best monsters to be synchro summoned. I'm not writing off Laval though. They can make an appearance maybe on the ladder, but in the meta tier list, not so sure about that. Now we keep going with the rest of the ultra and super rares I haven't mentioned so far. So we have Red Dragon Archman, the main attraction of the box. I would say so many people are excited for this card. In my opinion, in Duel Links currently, we don't have something that will be paired up with Red Dragon Archman and will immediately be amazing. So personally, I don't think the card is that amazing. Yes, it's way better than other Signer Dragons at the moment, but it's not anything crazy that will change Duel Links. It's cool we have it though. Next we have another synchro monster, Chaos King Archfiend. I believe it has a great effect, it is a good synchro monster, probably one of the best in the box, but currently it's not gonna find a deck that will make it amazing. It has future potential though, for sure. Next we have, after the Firefist cards, Vice Dragon. A dragon card that obviously can help you a lot in a synchro summoning deck. Other than that, maybe in a tribute deck, but I don't see the card being that useful or amazing in other situations. We also have Living Fossil, another card that can help you with synchro summoning, of course. I think it can be compared, and it needs to be compared, with Powerful Rebirth. Powerful Rebirth is a trap card, it needs to be set up for a turn, but it can be situationally better, because you don't lose all that attack when you special summon the monster from the graveyard. For synchro summoning, they can obviously both be used. In my opinion, Living Fossil, it's not worth for you to just open the box for this card. So next and lastly, from the ultra rare pile, we have Dark Bribe. Now this card, by a lot of people, is believed to be the next meta card as far as staples go in Duel Links. I tend to disagree a bit. I don't think it will be a staple like Canadia maybe is, or like Mirror World was back in the day. It can be useful though, don't get me wrong. I think it will be played in some decks. I just don't think that card is that good that you can open the box just for this one, let's say. Same with Living Fossil, pretty much. Can be useful, not worth to open the box just for them. But maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it will be one of the main cards that is used. Right now, at least, I don't see it. Now we go over to the Super Rare pile. I totally forgot to talk about Horse Prince on the Firefist segment. So it is a good card. It will be played, I think, in the Firefist decks. Next, we have Genex Ally Duradark. Meh, not anything crazy, in my opinion. Dread Dragon can be fine. I don't think it will see play at the moment. Three Trolling Trolls can actually be played in Fire Fists as well. Then we have Flame Veil Guard. It might seem like a garbage normal monster, but it is a tuner monster, so it might actually see some play. Then we get Alexandrite Dragon. It's too late for that, in my opinion. And then we have Skill Prisoner, a situational good card. Don't think it will see play. And lastly, we have Bad Aim, a card with an interesting effect, but I don't see it being good, just because if something bad is to happen to you by an activation of a card, let's say Wall of D, the fact that you can destroy another card on the field other than Wall of D won't stop the bad thing that will happen to you. So it's not the best. Other cards will totally be preferred over this one. So that is my general view of this main box. Now for the free-to-play opinion, I would advise every free-to-play player to skip this box. I won't buy it. I think that even if some of the archetypes in here are proven to be meta, especially Fire Fists and maybe even Nephthys, then most likely the decks won't be free-to-play friendly at all. So even if you go for this box and manage maybe to get some of the cards you need for the decks, it's not really easy to say that you will be building an optimal version of the deck as a free-to-play player. So that's why I would stay away from this box. Now if something is amazingly good and meta, which I don't think will happen, maybe yes, you can go for the box if you want to. But for that, we need to wait at least a week. Now, I'm gonna skip this box, so if you're free to play and agree with me, you may as well skip the box too. That is my opinion. I hope I helped you. If not, and you have some questions, feel free to ask me in the comments down below, like the review if you did, and of course, do not forget to subscribe for more Duel Links content. Thank you so much for watching. Join the Discord, link will be in the description. See you in the next one.